Thank you. Lord, that the parents of these young people will rejoice in that they have avoided the pitfalls of the unequal yoke and are being married together as Christians. Grant your blessing, we pray thee, upon this service, and we'll praise you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. The bride and groom invite you to be seated. The Christian marriage is a total commitment of two people to the person of Jesus Christ and to one another. It is a commitment in which there is no holding back of anything. Marriage is a pledge of mutual fidelity. It is a partnership of mutual subordination. A Christian marriage is similar to a solvent, a freeing up of the man and woman to be themselves and to become all that God intends for them to become. Marriage is a refining process that God will use to have us develop into the man or the woman he wants us to become. Into this holy estate, Becky and Tim now desire to enter. Who gives Becky to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Being the Savior of the body. But as the church is subject to Christ,
so also the wives ought to be to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, that he might present to himself the church in all her glory, having no spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and blameless. So husbands ought also to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his own wife loves himself, for no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as Christ also does the church, because we are members of his body. For this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This mystery is great, but I am speaking with reference to Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let each individual among you also love his own wife, even as himself, and let the wife see to it that she respect her husband.
Will you, Tim, have Becky to be your lawful wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony?
I will.
Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And will you, Becky, have Tim to be your lawful wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony?
I will.
Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
As you witness Tim and Becky's vows today, they ask each of us to accept responsibility for encouraging them and praying for them in their very life.
I, Tim, take you, Becky, to be my wife, to be my helper and companion as God intended marriage to be in the beginning. As your husband, I will nurture and cherish you as my own self, giving you the care, support, and encouragement you need to help fulfill your potential and to be all the woman God intended you to be. I promise to be a faithful and sacrificial husband to you as Christ is to the church. I promise you my deepest love, my unselfish devotion, and my tenderest care. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, my love for you will be patient and kind, not boastful or selfish, not arrogant or rude, or irritable or resentful. My love will always protect, always trust, always hold, and always endure. I also promise to tell you every day that I love you so you'll never have reason to doubt it. And because we've agreed that divorce is not an option, I commit my life unto you for the rest of our lives together, or until Christ comes again. I love you now and forever.
Sunshine when the skies are dark and burn.
patient, love is kind, and is not jealous. Love does not brag and is not arrogant, does not act unbecomingly. It does not seek its own, is not provoked, does not take into account a wrong suffered, does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. Gold, the purest of medalists, symbolizes the pureness of Christian marriage, and a circle symbolizes never-ending love. Repeat after me. Becky, I'm giving you this ring.
Becky, I'm giving you this ring.
As a lasting reminder of my vows.
As a lasting reminder of my vows.
And as a symbol of my love.
And as a symbol of my love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
Tim, I'm giving you this ring. As a lasting reminder of my vows.
As a lasting reminder of my vows.
And as a symbol of my love.
And as a symbol of my love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
Established today, would you join the bride and groom as they pray together.
Our Father and our God, we thank you for the very precious truth that you are unity and yet you are individuality in three persons. Such a beautiful symbol of what marriage is as we see it today. And such a wonderful privilege to enter into. We do pray for Beck and Tim today. Lord, we pray that their unity might truly be founded in the Lord Jesus Christ, who is all to them, as they have both confessed you. We praise you for that spiritual unity that they have. And we pray, dear Father, that in every way they may make an impact for this world as a couple together, glorifying you, establishing a new home in this day and age when Satan tries so hard to destroy that which is so beautiful in the home. We pray that this home may indeed be a glory to your precious name. And yet we thank you for their individuality. We thank you for Becky and our Father. We pray that as she becomes Mrs. Fulmer, she might find it a liberating experience as a woman, as an individual, to leave the name Miss Lenz and become Mrs. Fulmer. And that her individuality might be a compliment and be a blessing and be a help, because you designed her to be a helpmeet to her husband. And then for Tim, dear Father, we remember him knowing that in the establishment of a new home, Tim is the priest of that home. And Father, we pray that he might indeed be the true spiritual leader. We commit him to you. We know that this home will be attacked by Satan. We pray that he may take all the armor of God that is at his disposal to truly lead his family, his home, into the ways of God. And so we commit them individually as two people, but joined into one, and pray that these days ahead for Tim and Becky may indeed be days of heaven on earth as they establish their home and marriage. To that end, we dedicate them to their future lives for your honor and glory. In Jesus' precious name, we thank you.
Let them flow and cease. Let us breathe. Thank you. Is this one in now?
No.
No.